Okay, good morning everybody. I would like to welcome everyone to our today's session, Dynamo webinar within the Dynamo Express series. And today we have a talk about LS Prepost. So my colleague Silvia is going to show you a little bit what you can do with LS Prepost, maybe give you some hints or tips on how to deal with it and what kind of possibilities it's offering. And yeah, Silvia, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, so then now the webinar is yours. And yeah, see you later then.
Okay, thank you to Mike for the introduction. Hello and welcome everyone to the LS Prepost webinar. My name is Silvia Mandl and I'm a project engineer at Dynamo, working at the Dynamo office here in Dresden in Germany. I'm going to talk in this presentation in the next hour about news, tips and tricks for the LS Prepost user. This webinar is a part of the Dynamo Express sessions. If you have any questions or comments, you are welcome to contact me at silvia.mandl@dynamo.de. There will be time for questions at the end of the presentation too. The picture, the LS Prepost GUI. LS Prepost, often abbreviated as LSPP, is an advanced pre- and post-processor that is delivered free of charge with LSDyna. It is designed and developed like LSDyna from the company LSTC, which belongs now to ANSYS. LS Prepost supports a wide range of all LSDyna applications in pre-processing and post-processing in one single code. LS Prepost also provides geometry function, meshing features and scripting capabilities to automate on an easy way your processes. In this presentation, I will introduce some of the new features. I will also present tips and tricks for toolbar modification, meshing, data output, scripting, and check tools for troubleshooting. I will explain some topics which are very frequently asked in our support channels too. I structured this talk in these 7 points. At first, some remarks to the LS Prepost software installation. After the installation process, I will show how the user can adjust the GUI display and make user LSPP settings. The pre- and post-processing as the core of LS Prepost has many new features. I will show the nice tool LS1 to start LSDyna jobs with a queuing manager and many other useful related options. Of course, the model checking tools are very helpful to avoid modeling errors and faster correct simulation runs. The process automation tools of LS are more and more in demand and are easy to realize in LS Prepost. At the end of the webinar, I will give, of course, a short summary with the recent development notes. On this slide, you see below a download link because for some features in this presentation, I prepare for you some examples. In these example files and also the presentation slides, you can download with this link. I will write this link at the end of the presentation in the webinar chat. So now I start with some installation remarks of the latest versions. First, since March this year, Dynamo has a new client server for the software sharing, like LS Prepost software. The current LS Prepost release version is updated nearly every month in this server because of bug fixing. Nearly every week, the development version receives an update because of new feature implementations. The next point is new but still correct. LS Prepost is free, and this point is probably in this time very interesting, because many of our users had to switch fast in the home office and they were happy that the LS Prepost installation on their home office laptops was so easy and without license problems. The current official release version is LS Prepost 4.7. One remark to this version is the old GUI is not supported anymore. After more than 10 years, the toggle option between old interface and new interface by function key 11 has been discontinued. If you have still problems with the change, please contact us and we will help you. In this little picture, you can see where you have to click to see all new functions in LS Prepost 4.7. The new feature list is very long, and so I present today only some of these features from this list. For example, if you are interested in new geometry function, please look on this release notes to read many points of new geometry features. I also present in this webinar many new features of the development version 4.8. And an official version release is nearly every year. So I guess this development version will be released at the end of the year as the official version. Now I have a video of the Linux user since July 2019. One LSPPost installation is running on all Linux systems, and this version is called Common Version. So now the user don't need a separate installation package for CentOS 6, CentOS 7, Ubuntu, and so on. You start LSPPost in Linux with the including start script LSPP47. But if you have not the correct OpenGL support on your system, for example, you don't have a good graphic card like NVIDIA or troubles with the OpenGL support via SSH connection, please try the LSPP47 MESA script, which uses a MESA library. So after you install successfully your version, I can make probably some user settings, for example, the display setting of the GUI. Of course, you know, you can toggle on off, for example, this nice feature tree on the left side. You can make on off the simulation titles, fringe legend. You can switch background colors and many more. You know it. But one thing is probably unknown. And this interface has been more and more new features in the last time. The toolbar manager. This toolbar manager can organize which tool icons are visible in the bottom toolbar, on the right toolbar, and also in the transparent toolbar, which means the main window, and in which order the tool icons are visible. This is sometimes useful if you know that you do not need the geometry function or post-processing in LSPP, so you can get use or reorder the tools. Or you have to support a team which has to use LSPPost in a workflow only for a short process steps with only one step or so. Then you can help your colleagues by preparing LSPPost to a GUI which offers only this process steps to avoid activating some settings which could be changed, for example, the target model result view for this process step. Click on main menu setting toolbar manager, which opens this window. The first checkbox option is allow directly editing on toolbar. With this option, you can swap the tool order or track tools to another toolbar, like the bottom toolbar or the favorites. I can simply drag and drop in the GUI. The related third checkboxes below are for activating which drag and drop function for the tools you want to allow. And additionally, the next checkbox drag out prompt is that a pop-up window will appear and prompt you to confirm your new toolbar icon order. The last checkbox on the top of the toolbar manager is to dock the pop-up dialog windows on the right toolbar. Do you know the collect button for the bottom toolbar here? This is to collect multiple tools, for example, all the mesh render function in a drop-down button like this. And now I want to show you function directly in LSPPost. Perhaps the many tools on the right and the bottom are too much. So you open the toolbar manager. You can select the bottom toolbar on the right to reduce the icons. You can highlighting with the shift key many tools and deactivate which tools should be available. Click on the arrow which shows out of the box. You can reset it, the reset button. Then you can deactivate, for example, in five main geometry icons. You can click the main mesh icon, and the sub icons can be modified. For example, you don't need the NURBS meshing, or you often use for meshing the point to mesh feature. And so you like to see this tool at first in the meshing tool list. At the end, you have to click apply and then you see the reduced tool. Okay, so the toolbar manager also permits a range of options for positioning of macro icons. Macros are user tools which execute LS People's comments, and I will explain the macro topic in a detail later in the automation chapter. But macro icon positioning can be done very comfortable here in the toolbar manager by clicking on the arrow next to transparent toolbar. The macro icons are moved by default in the transparent toolbar, which means directly in the main GUI window here. With the add macro button, you can add a new macro icon. With move custom, you can move the icon to the bottom toolbar or favorite icons in the right toolbar. I like to show you this feature with our little test Lego car, which my colleagues from Scale and Dynamo are used for the first simulation runs in preparing the probably well-known LS Dyna Lego crash simulations Porsche models. Here you see the little test car, and I need a macro. So I add a macro, click apply, and then I show you I can move this macro. I can load a C file, this comments I'll explain later. I give a title, car, because I can change with this C file the part class, and I can also modify the icon. And then you see it's modified here in the transparent toolbar. I go again in the toolbar manager and say, okay, I need it in the favorite menu. Move to custom, apply, close, and now I check. Yes, it is here. And I can execute now for every session I start this C file. So again, if I have many variants of this calculation and I have to make picture or movies or only for presentation, I can use this C file to change the colors very easy and fast. So these toolbar modification and also nearly other display options are saved in configuration files, and LS PeoPost use this new config for every LS PeoPost start. So these settings you changed in the Q&A sessions are automatically saved and will be available in the next LS PeoPost session. Some additional interesting display options are in the main menu settings, configuration settings. For example, you can change there the font colors or font sizes and many more. One new button is the reset config button there. This is useful because sometimes the user did so much different display changes and then the user like to reset the default settings. I think it is useful if the user understands and knows where the configuration files are saved. These are all the configuration files, which contains the lsppcon file, which stores general configuration parameters. lsppLastTouch file stores last session window size, dialog location, file path, etc. Then the configure toolbar file is to store toolbar configuration like we has done in the toolbar manager. And at the last, the lsppRecen file stores recently used files and their location. The LSPP version 4.6, 4.7, or the dev version 4.8 has its own directory, and you can see here the path for Windows and also for Linux. You can also check the current path by clicking on File Config in the configuration settings menu interface. With this button, you can also change the config directory path. You can also use the environment variable LSCC file to set the config file. But this is really for professional users useful. For example, you can define this environment variable in a start script of LSPP, and the user of the start script has no write permission for this LSCC file directory. So you can predefine for your user team the settings, for example, that all output values should be in decimal notation or with two digits after the decimal point. So now I start with the pre and post processing features. I don't split it in two chapters because on the one side, many features are used in pre and post. And on the other side, more and more users working with imported keyword files and result files to the same time. For example, you open the input and the result files with file open at a Steiner keyword and DC plot. And then you can check the simulation one and recognize that you define a high initial velocity or forget a pre-stress at one screw. So you can correct immediately in this open LS pre-possession the keyword and start simulation one again. So let us start with the new features. And at the end, I come to the frequently asked question in pre and post processing. In the development version 4.8, there is a new option keyword card in the identify interface, which also pop up the keyword input form here for checking or modification when identify, for example, by picking a part or element or a node ID. Since version 4.7, the option to save your keyword files in LSTP in the E10 input format is available to expand the default E8 fields to 10 characters, thereby accommodating larger nodes and element IDs, for instance. This is a less drastic change to the input format than going to long format, where all input variables, both real and integer, are expanded to 20 characters. Probably you know the feature in model display to highlight it on a nice way different keyword definition in the model. For example, you can show contact slaves and master sets or boundary definitions in the model. You can also make a pre-watch with entity preview of your boundary per scap motion definition to check if you select the correct parts or define the correct motion direction. Since version 4.7, there is a new button sort by available to get a table view of all your defined contact options, like you see here in this slide. The basic sort by function is like in the part selection menu here, which also provides this sort by table only by parts since a long time. Then, LSP Post supports this keyword set part tree data. The set part tree is a new definition in LSDynr, which allows user to organize the model with part data in a hierarchical manner for easy manipulation and visualization. This data is also stored in the D3 plot files for post processing. And if you want to show the set part tree in LSP Post, click on the main menu view and then subset explorer. And then you see this nice tree structure, and you can highlight it, these set parts. You can click on, off, blank, create, remove, delete, or move. There is a new advanced on-screen measuring ruler available, which is useful if the user likes to see the approximate size of the model, for example, in picture printouts. Since version 4.7, it is also possible to measure the distance between two similar models in LSP Post. Like you see, I have opened two similar models here in this LSP Post GUI with different positions, and I click really, you see the same number IDs, and I can measure the distance. Since version 4.7, it is possible to split T-shell elements in the element editing tool. You can split the elements in different layers and direction. In LSDynr, there are the keyword define table 2D and 3D available. You can make 3D graphic plots in this interface starting in application and then 3D graphics viewer. By the way, you can use this 3D graphics viewer for all 3D plots of curve. Since version 4.5, you can start a solution explorer in the main window view. And this solution explorer is a new way to set up LS-DYNA models and also to analyze the simulation runs of this created LS-DYNA models. Currently, simulation setup of incompressible CFD, implicit, and since the version 4.8, structured AIL model is included. The intention behind is that if you need, for example, an implicit simulation run, the Solution Explorer helps and predefined as much as possible the many options for implicit simulation. This makes the simulation setup a little bit easier and more intuitive compared to the conventional keyword setup. My colleagues at Dynamo Nordic are supported this development very much, and if you need an example or tutorial, please contact us. Since a long time, LSPPost has a mapping tool and via menu mesh and then result mapping to map result values from a solid mesh to a shell and another shell or solid mesh, or from a shell mesh to a solid or another shell mesh. Since version 4.8, you can map also scalar values of X, Y, Z positions to a mesh. For example, you have a pressure field based on X, Y, Y, Z coordinates for a workpiece from a test result. So now you have to map these scalar values on your FE mesh. So you can start the interface result mapping and load the ASCII file, like here you see with the pressure values. In this option scalar to history value. Then specify in the from list which scalar value you want to map from your file. In this example, I have only one scalar value after the XYZ coordinates. And then, so I put one in this field. Then define in the two column to which history value you like to map the values. And then you can, for example, output these map these mapped values for every element in a DYNA in file with initial stress cards to use these initial values for simulation runs. Or you can also compare these test results values with your simulation results. For this, you can calculate the difference with a fringe expression, and many more interesting options are available in LS Prepost. I attached an example for this feature in the download package. The following slide is more a tip for the users, and I also an introduction for the next slide. Did you know that you have a right mouse click option in the keyword manager? For example, the transfer to option is useful if you want to change the contact type, for example, from surface to service to nodes to service, but you want leave your defined contact option or like save master path or friction values and so. Then you make a right mouse click on the source keyword here. And then you get a few of transfer option in this dialog window. For example, you can delete the source keyword or you can keep it. You can use this transfer option for many keywords. If you open by double click a keyword, you get this keyword input form. And then you have on the right side a list from all entities which are defined with this keyword. If you want to change one value or replace one value to another for many of this list, you can make a right mouse click, click on replace file and replace file value, and you will see also a few of replacing options. For example, you can reduce the replace process only for a special ID number range defined with a colon like contact ID 200 to 500 here. So many options are possible there. Then and now in 4.8 version, we have another right mouse click option to import CSV curve files and transform these curves to the keyword define curve or define table. So you have this, for example, this input file and then I get in the correct keyword defined table and so on. And I have attached also an example file for you to try it. In LS-Dyna, there is a new option pen out on control output for DCplot and npen on database extent info keyword, which writes penetration information to the DCplot and info file. And this is now supported from LSPPost. LSPPost displays this penetration information in the interface, for example, in post vector, and then there's the option penetration. And also, you have the option to fringe the penetration values in the nodal displacement value tab in the fringe component interface. And there's also an example for this feature. More and more high order elements are available in LS-Dyna. In the interface mesh element generation, you have the possibility to convert very easy your basic elements to high order elements and also back. You see a list of some conversion option. If you want to see the mid-side nodes in LSPPost of the high order elements, you can activate the display via view show mid-side nodes. The interface model create identity is to create, show, modify, and delete a view of entity in a more comfortable way as in the keyword manager. For example, you can define load and motions, constraints, widget walls, cross section, or sets. Since version 4.7, you can create segments also on the basis of high order elements, as you see here in this picture. In the fringe component menu is a new option, normalization here. To easily visualize the paths that have the stress over certain value, you need to open the DSP plot file and the keyword files. This option works only for MET24. The post trace function now as only a tip. Is to trace points, nodes, streamlines, paths, center of gravity, or curves during a simulation. This is not possible with default settings if you have mesh additivity in the model. A tip from my side, because of it's a frequently asked question, if you want to trace a point of a model with mesh additivity, you have to use the D3 trace option in control adaptive. For example, if you want to know the material for in a rivet joint simulation, like here you see in the picture. There is an option in the main menu view to show results on screen. If you display a color fringe plot, you can click on the element tool ident on an element, and the result value is visible directly on the model. Since version 4.7, this show result is also working for the vector plots in the post vector menu. As you can see, on the tip of the arrow is the result value. By the way, in the configuration settings interface, you can change the default exponential output format to a decimal format with defined decimal digit numbers. Since version 4.8, the media tool in the main menu, application tools, media, is improved. You can now import MP4 movies, and the general dialogue workflow is improved. One important point is that you should have the same number of frames in your movies like states in your simulation. In my work, I use a script which reads the state numbers, a SCL script which reads the state numbers and adjusted then with an external movie tool automatically the correct frame numbers. LSPPost offers also in the media tool movie cutting option to make the frame and state numbers equal. I mean the button set last or set first or entering frame start and end number. Then if you have the same number, the movie and the modulation slides below are switched from deactivated to selectable here. The movie tool offers three different show types. The overlay, vertical, and horizontal show type. The overlay option is really nice if you make your simulation model transparent before in the part. Material Test Center in Stuttgart. Then you see here now the failure in the material. So since version 4.8, you can now also activate an option in the main menu show a main view menu show deleted elements only. Before, there was only show deleted elements possible, and the user has to use difficult workarounds to identify better in the models the deleted elements. Now it's better. Yes, you know the LSDA format, and in order to avoid writing data to DSV plot file, more new result data in LSDynr are being outputted as LSDA format. And as people support fringing the LSDA format and the input in general, and the LSDA file can also has multiple time steps like spin out file, one can also animate the change of the fringe data. The model itself came from keyboard files, fringe data came from LSDA file. It is possible to view MPP domain decomposition, which LSDynr output. And you can read this and animate in the view interface in LS Prepost. LS Prepost supports the XFAM QUEC file and QUEC visualization via the QUEC interface in the post main menu. And you can load these QUEC files and change the line white, the line color, and animate it. Of course, in NVH applications, LS Prepost is more and more improved, and I get the information that the D3FTG format, the new format, is also supported. Also, and I get the information that the structure A visualization is improved more and more, as you can see in these pictures. Since version 4.8, IGA support is extended and improved more and more. For example, now the IGA keywords are available in the keyword manager. And also the solid IGA text format is now supported. Now, some little interesting features. Perhaps you have a model with large model dimension, then you can click on settings, post settings, displacement scale factor. And there's a new option in since 4.7 with the relative option. And it calculates the proportional ratio of the maximum deformation to the largest model dimension. So the greater the model, the greater the deformation scaling. So if the automatically calculated relative factor is too big, reduce it, for example, to 10% in this input field. And perhaps you don't know that we have also a reduced DSV plot file option in the save as menu. And there you can reduce the states, or you can define a maximum output file size for the DSV plot files. Then everyone knows the old plot manager, and I want to inform that they have another since nearly now also a long time XY plot manager. Sometimes it's called 2D graphics viewer, and this is designed as a to plot many more curves in a page by page systems. And to start this plot manager, you have two options. The first one is click on the in the bottom toolbar icon, this one, plot manage, or you in every curve selection interface you have a main option. Normally for the old plot window you click is pop up and activated, but you have to click on main, and then this 2D graphic viewer is started, and also at the same time you get from your curve plot window directly in the main window. If you don't like to see it, you can deactivate it in the graphics viewer window with this hue show port, then you don't see it. You can also move it or resize it with the right mouse click option. The best way to move this curve is shift control and mouse left button to track the plotting port area on this main window. Yeah. Some advantages compared to the old plot window is you have possibility to plot multiple curves in multiple pages. You can modify the election position, that is not possible in the old, and you have the option to create cross plot curves with cross plotting, and before in the old interface you have to start another interface cross or XY plot cross, and so it's easier. And you have a template option to save curve plot settings like the line color, line style and name. So this is also a tip. It's not only for metal forming simulation users, because if you need a mesh, a shell mesh, like this, where the at the edges, it's a more finer, like this, bit more finer mesh in this way for adaptivity, you can click this one. Adaptive boundary option in the mesh plank measure option. One very frequently asked question, how can I modify the fringe legend? And there you can make also a right mouse click on the fringe legend, and you can change, for example, the label of the fringe legend, the size, you can move it on a other position, or you change the fringe levels or the exponential format to decimal format. Then a very frequently asked question is, how can I activate user coordinate systems? So there you have to load the keyword file and the DSP plot files of the model. And then go in settings, general settings, there is a option local chord system. And if you predefine a coordinate system in, for example, define coordinate nodes, then you will read it in this list and you can select it. Or you can create with another new coordinate system in the Cartesian, cylindrical or spherical coordinate system. Then if you want to fringe values on your model, you can go to post fringe component and you have to check if the default DSP plot option is changed to user. Then this your activated local coordinate system is selected. It belongs to the same problem, and you have to know it, the difference. You can have user local coordinate system, but you can also select the local element system. The local element system is based on the element node numbering in the keyword element. So node 1 and node 2 is the x-axis. And here you have to load again the keyword file and the DSP plot file of the model. Click on view, activate local access, and then you can work in the local element system. So you can also check element direction with element tool ident and the element dear option here in the identify interface, and you see the direction of the x-axis, and you can make fringe plots in the fringe component interface, and here you have to check if these three plot is checked, is switched to element in this interface, then you have the correct fringe plot values in element system. And if you have curve plots, you, for example, in the history interface, look if the element axis is from local, is in local definition. Then also a tip, of frequently asked question, how can I select shell outline nodes? Like in this picture, I need this selection of these nodes on the outline of the shell part. The problem is that for complex outlines, no simple option is available in the normal selection dialog window of LSPPO. So you can select the edge, the edge, the edge, but it's for complex it's parts, it's difficult. So I have a trick for you. Click on the geometry tool curve, then S-spline, select the method from mesh hole, activate outer hole, apply, and you get a curve at first on this outline nodes. Then go in the mesh element generation interface and click beam. And so you create a beam part by the curve part, curve. And then you have the beam elements directly on the nodes of the shell outline nodes. And you have to merge the duplicated nodes with element tools duplicate nodes, keep smaller node ID, show duplicate nodes, merge duplicate nodes, and accept. The same thing for solid parts is a little bit easier. You only have to go on mesh element generation, shell by solid surface, and you get a part on the surface of the solid, a shell part. And then you only have to delete the upper and lower surface by element edit. And you can use this is a little selection window, and you can click propagate and select an angel. And so all elements which have a maximum angel to each other of 5 degrees are selected. So the upper and lower surface, and then are deleted, and then I have the nodes. And then you can use these nodes, outline node parts, for making, for example, set nodes for boundary SPCs definition, for example. So this is a workaround, so a tip in this webinar. And also a frequently asked question is, so how can I make fringe plots with my user values? So, for example, you have a project where I have a big expression behind it. You calculate really with, so based on the material card or something else, some limits, and you want to make a calculation and so on. So you have create user values for example, for every element. So, and then you have to check, is this a total or an element result at first? Then I need the output form, the input format. And the best way is to make at first an output of any fringe. Do you make, so for example, the Farnese stress or something else, which is available in LSPPost. And then I want to inform you have the post output interface here. And then you can select, which is very useful, you can geometry output in this or keywords, diner in and so on. And you can select the element results or nodal results and for the queue and state and find it in the output file. Then you can modify this output files for your user values, perhaps with a script or something else. And then you can go import this in fringe component to import the user values in the user tab, user element values or node values. And One important point is always, which makes question for the users, please check if you want to finish your values with nodal averaging or no nodal average. So you have to go and post finch range, and then you have this option. Yeah, that was my information for the pre and post features. Then if you have finished the setup of your keyword model, then you want to start LSDynA. So, and there is in directly in the LS prepost package, the tool LS1, and you can start it with file start LSDynA LS1 started. And on Microsoft Windows, the LS1 software is a preferred method to start your LSDynA simulation. LS1 provides a queuing system to manage your LSDynA simulations and managing of running and finish simulation, including starting LS prepost, etc. You can define your access to all LSDynA menus. You can install and check the LSDynA license and license server. And also you can define the passes to examples, tutorials, benchmark, and guidelines for LSDynA. This is the interface of LS1. And yeah, automatically, if you have open a model and you start LS1 about the main file menu, the input file is in this line, and then you can select your solver. You can define how much number of CPU you want to use in your system, the memory, and you get a preview for the LSDynA command line, which execute starts the LSDynA run. You can check it. And you can, this is a start button, you can reply a job, and you here you have some possibilities to start log files or the input files or the message files of LSDynA and so on. And there, here is a setting menu, and this is for more detailed settings. For example, if I want to open the simulation results, you can define a special LS prepost version, you can define a text editor, or where is your manuals saved, the path. You have also a nice dialogue window to set your license server. Yeah. So if you have questions there, if you have problems to define your, to start your LSDynA run, of course, Dynamo will support you. Then model checking tools is more and more important to get a faster, correct run. And I want to show you how you can check your tools in LS prepost. In the application main menu, there's a tool model checking. And there, click on general checking. If you have not an A model, general checking, then you have different tabs. The last one, model check setting, is only to define how much is your maximum warpage value and so on. And the first one is element quality. You can check it. You can select which kind of checking method you want to have. And you can save the elements which failed for this type. You can delete it, you can report it in a output file. Then you have the next tab is a keyword check. You get a list which is an error, which is a warning, which keywords are unreferenced or undefined. And you can make a double click on this error warnings and so on, and you get this little information window and with more detailed information to the problem, and you can read also, or you start the keyword input form if you want to check in detail your different keyword definition or modify it. Then also the third tab is a contact check, and you can check if you have penetration in contacts, or for tight contacts you can check if the nodes are constrained or not tight. And yeah, you can display it like you see it here, and you can have different options. And one new option is, since version 4.7, the write button, so you can write out the check results also in an output file. One interesting other model tool is MISC, and in the MISC menu, the D3 HSP view. So Alice Diner, as I said, D3 HSP file contains a lot of information for the Alice Diner one, like a log file of Alice Diner, and you can, Alice People reads the information from the D3 HSP file and organize it into a tree list structure for easy reading. A key phrase search is also possible, and all entities which are highlighted in blue can be displayed directly in the model. For example, you want to check the elements with the timestamp, perhaps they have a problem if they are a wrong mesh, and you can click it and check it directly. If you have an implicit simulation run, there is nice statistic plot options available in this interface, like you see here in the right side. So for example, you can plot the number of iterations to convergence for over the implicit time steps. And you can see if there are a problem in your iterations. The automation chapter, it is really important and more frequently asks, how can I automate my process in LSP post? So especially for post-processing, but also more and more pre-processing. So you know, the most user know it, you have all, almost all graphical user interface interaction generates a comment, and these comments are written to a file called lspost.c file. And this file is created in the same directory as the input file, and it can be modified to help automate the task. And different option, you can other comments added, like skip and skip, or you can add the comment interactive. So if you execute such a C file, you can make some interactive steps in the GUI and click escape if you're ready, and the LSP post C file execution will be continued. And how can I open this C file? You can make it in the directly in the GUI with this file open comment file, or you can also put it in macros, or you can do it in the comment start comment line of LSP post and terminals. For example, the Linux user will do it in this way, LSP post, and then you have a C and the comment C file, and if starts at LSP post GUI and executes the C file, or you write no graphics, then you don't see the graphic user interface. But this option still requires the graphics hardware and software. So, but if you have a C file which don't make pictures or movies, then you really not need the graphical user interface, and then you can try this comment 1c, which is really truly no graphics operation. So, but if you want to have make prints as picture outputs, for example, on a server which has no graphic card, then you have to use this C minus no graphics option and start before a virtual frame buffer system and so on. So in this C file, you can use also parameters, as I, the definition is here visible. The imp- important comment file are listed in the main menu help documentation comments. The best way is try it in your notebook graphic, in your GUI first time, and then modify the created lspost.c file. And if you need a support, we are ready to help you. A new is in the comment file that you can retrieve a variable by a comment. So this is an example, and you can try it with the same example like I documented here. So if you, for example, identify an element with the maximum Polonius stress in the simulation run. So before I don't know where is this element. So and I get the information, okay, this is this element here. And then I selected this element by this comment here, variable one, and this adds the element ID in the selection. And then I can automatically plot, for example, the effective stress for this, for me, unknown ID element. So you can try it and do it. So again, macros. That's it for the icons important. If you want to add macros, and there you can create macros in the MISC menu with start recording comments and launch macro interface or manage comment file. There are different operations, and it's not so complicated. Then you have the scripting comment language. It's a C-like programming language to be executed within LSPPost. And it can also execute the LSPPost C file comments. And you have the option to use if, then, else, or while loops, and so on. And you have different application programming interface APIs to extract model data, result data from the LSPPost database. Yeah, and we have the documentation on our Dynamo client server for you. And there are two ways to execute the SCL file in LSPPost. Directly in the command line in the GUI in LSPPost with one script SCL file, or the user interface over the application main menu and select customize and run it. There are also improvements in the last versions for SCL, so they add more option for data extraction, for example, for SPH elements. For you can have a comment to get the number of active elements which are currently on screen, get the array contains the active elements IDs, and more and more. For example, also just, you can extract nodal coordinates at different state. So the best way, if the user missed something, please inform us and we can add the function. So that brings me to the end of my presentation. At this point, at first, the recent developments. The developers will try to improve more and more the user interface to make it more and more user-friendly. Then Dynamo is testing currently a new LSPPost version with Python scripting function, and this feature will be available in the next weeks. And of course, also improvements extension for the Solution Explorer. And the summary is LSPPost has been keeping up with the rapid development of LSDyna, both in pre-processing and post-processing. And so many features and capabilities were implemented based on user requests and suggestions. And Dynamo works directly together with the LSPPost developers. And so customer requests can be discussed very fast with the LSPPost manager, Philip Ho, at ANSYS and his developer team. At this point, I want to say thank you to the close and pleasant cooperation with the developers and for the providing of news information for this presentation. Dynamo and LSP Post developers would like to support our customers by improving and speed up the pre and post processes for Celis Dynamo simulation. And the Dynamo LSP Post support team and the whole team of LSP Post developers are open to advice and happy to listen to our customers for their needs. So I hope you enjoyed the presentation. LSP Post has so many interesting features, and today I have only time for a short overview. So you are welcome to find me your question, requests, or process problems in the chat, or better by mail at support@dynamo.de. And in this support system, the LSP Post support team from Germany and my LSP Post support colleagues Pierre from the Dynamo France office in Versailles and David from the Dynamo Swiss office in Zurich are ready to help our customers all over the world. Also, my Swedish Dynamo Nordic colleague Anders Jenberg, who is also an LSP Post developer, is a big support, especially if you want to know fast exactly which calculation is behind the post component value in the LSPP code, or short bug fixes or simple new implementation can be done by Dynamo. So thank you very much for your attention. I'd be glad to answer any question you might have.
Well, thank you for your attention, and then see you next week again for the last one of the pre-summer holiday session, and then we're going to continue with this Dynamo webinars in, I think, in September. So there will be no webinars in August. So we're going to continue in September. Okay, thank you everybody, and stay healthy, stay safe, and see you next week then.
Bye.
Bye-bye.